Hello. Good morning. Happy Saturday. It's been a long time since I've streamed. I might have just been busy. I mean, what did I do last week? Oh yeah, I went on a hike. Though that was kind of like later in the day. I
Rat
probably could have
poor
done a short
girl.
stream, but didn't. And then let me see how if I remember the controls here. And then the week before that, I had Easter celebration with my family, even though it wasn't Easter weekend, because my parents went to Puerto Rico during the actual Easter weekend, so celebrated a different weekend. And yeah, so just been, I think it's been 3 weeks, or unless I skipped the 1 week before that too. I don't think that I did though, but that's a long time for me. I'm like pretty darn consistent when it comes to streaming though, generally speaking. So I won't say the break wasn't bad. It was kind of nice. Two. What's up, Jordan? Thanks for the 67 months. We're so close. Talk to Popola. That's where we're at. Okay. Yeah. So this past few weeks been good. Like I said, celebrated Easter. I had my birthday. I'm 32 now. Went on a hike with some friends. That was a really good time. And then we went to get Indian food, which was great. Indian food's like a cuisine that I really know nothing about. I get like the very basics, you know. How you been, Jordan? What's up? Oh yeah, I'm gonna do a quick recap. So last stream we did the City of Facade, which is really cool when they have like a billion rules. And then freed the prince there. I don't really remember what we got out of it, like story-wise, what we got out of it. And then we, towards the end of the stream, we were just doing some side quests, and then we had a vision, or a dream rather. Both Yona and I had a dream that this guy, I think, was like mouthing words to us, and it said sealed verse. I don't exactly remember more than that. It might have been a few more details than that. Maybe we'll get into it in this conversation here.
What's up, Popola?
Oh, hi. I just got a strange letter in the mail.
Dearest Popola, I hope this letter finds you well. I'm writing in hopes of bringing to your attention a certain dream issue of concern regarding recent events in Dream the Village. Recent events in Dream the Village. I was hoping I might be dream able. What? Dream able to get your advice stream on the matter. Recently, there have been dream reports, dream of a certain dream of dream, evil dream, empty dream, curse dream, evil dream, words, dream, and dream, someone dream. Okay, let me try and read this without the dreams here. See if there's noted. Oh, I should add that emote. Can you add emotes for me? Like at FMC? I don't know. I like noted though. That's a good emote. Recently, there have been dream reports of a certain dream of evil, curse, evil words, and some. Okay.
That is certainly one bizarre piece of writing.
You can't watch out your computer. Oh, gotcha. You're Gucci, just having some cereal and coffee. Oh, nice. Okay, good. This morning I had a bowl of cereal, and a banana, and water, which is more than most of my mornings. So I feel like I'm doing pretty well.
Who's it from?
The mayor of a small village in the Forest of Myth. It's a wooded area up north.
Okay.
The Forest of Myth?
They're usually a bright and cheerful group of people.
What a silly name.
Something like this is very out of character for them.
How can there be a forest of myth if it's real? I guess myth can be real? Is that true? Or is that the definition of myth that it's not real? I don't know. They're usually a bright and cheerful group of people. Something like this is very uncanny.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I'll check it out.
You will? But...
Don't worry about it. I've got business there anyway.
Do we?
Oh, well, alright.
Wait, did the dream... Thank you. Did our dream tell us the forest of myth? I don't remember. That's probably correct, though. We gotta go north. How do I view map again? Is it select? Okay. I can just follow the axe too. Can I jump? Yeah. What are my side quests? Was I in the middle of any side quests? One thing I remember from last stream is that I tried the gardening feature, or the gardening thing in this game, and everything died. And I was like, well, that was silly and dumb. Orders? No. Oh. Grimmar Vice. Incomplete quest. Letter to a lover. Wanna go to the Airy. Oh no, catching fish? All my homies love fishing. Okay. Owned. We haven't been anywhere near this area, I don't think, yet, so. This'll be new. It's pretty. It's like lightning bugs. Sonic the Warthog. Yes! Now, it is very fast. Here. What's up, Brandon? How are you?
There's trouble on the way. I'm certain of it.
You know, a little optimism now and then wouldn't hurt, Vice.
Good morning, such Shan. How are you? Good morning, fellow weeaboos. So, Megan, my girlfriend, I taught her what the word weeb means, and she has found way more use out of it than I expected her to for such a odd word. I think I have an anime night, and we both had plans one night. She had her plans, and I had she had Bible study, and I had anime night. I said, "Have a good Bible study," and she said, "Have fun with your fellow weebs." And then she's okay. I don't know if you guys interview people. I know Jordan interviews people. I don't know if you ever look them up beforehand, whether like social media or whatever, but Megan was looking at someone's like Facebook, and they posted like anime stuff, and then her boss was like, "Did you find anyone interesting in the applicants?" And then she asked, and then Megan says, "Do you know what a weeb is?" And so she taught her boss what a weeb was. It's great. Alright, we're in the forest of myth. Good stuff. But yeah, Shane and Brandon, how are you guys? What did I just pick up? I I want to be able to sort by when I got something. I think it's a tree branch, which is not very exciting. The mayor.
The words? What do you mean?
Contagious words.
This is a cool area. This is pretty.
Those who dream.
Those who dream?
Hold a moment. There is a strange new sensation in my mind.
Vice's voice rose in a quizzical way.
It is not quizzical.
What's going on?
Was that a fourth wall break by Vice? Like, I don't know. That was weird. The villager's body shuddered as he slowly opened his eyes.
Perhaps we should start by asking this man.
Don't they get him ready for Weeb games tonight? Okay, we're playing Tokaido. I was thinking maybe of bringing, I got Pandemic and Horrified over from Christmas. I've played Pandemic. Pandemic's actually pretty fun. I haven't won a game yet. I've only played one game of it, with Megan. And then Horrified, I want to try Horrified. Haven't done that one, but that's a co-op one. I like co-op games.
Who are you?
We heard something happened to this village, so we came to see if we could help.
The mayor stared at B and Vice.
If you can speak to me, I must have caught you in my dream.
Interesting. Okay.
In your dream?
The mayor explained. In the past weeks, a mysterious disease called the Death Dream had spread across the Forest of Myth. Those who caught it were cursed to fall asleep and live forever within the world of their own dreams. Oh, that's wild. That's like Inception. I don't know. Yeah, Brigham, you don't have any other plans other than Tokaido. Okay, gotcha. The village mayor had determined the death dream was spread from person to person by spoken words. Oh, but before he could learn more, the disease took him as well. Vice stared at the mayor, his mouth twitching slightly.
Now see here. Are you saying that we have been absorbed into your dream?
Well, yes. I think you have.
In other words, we've caught the death dream?
Before the mayor could confirm B's suspicion, Vice exploded with rage.
Ridiculous. Preposterous. Completely unfathomable on every conceivable level. I don't even recall falling asleep.
That's just how the death dream works.
Though polite, the mayor was clearly trying to brush aside the book's remarks.
My remarks are not to be brushed aside, fool.
The mayor twisted his mouth into an embarrassed grimace, then quickly changed the subject to who B had seen and what they had discussed since coming to the village.
Something there must have caused you to enter my dream. A certain conversation, a specific word, something.
B and Vice racked their brains, but could find no easy solutions. There are simply too many words to consider, too many random chatter, too much random chatter, too many meaningless conversations.
Grimoire Vice does not engage in meaningless conversations.
The mere suggestion that Vice chose his words carelessly seemed to sting his pride.
It does not seem to sting my pride, you bloated gas bag of a narrator. It has demolished it utterly.
Irritated, Vice looked skyward, as if searching for answers in the heavens.
I was doing no such thing. Just leave me alone already.
This is great. The anger created by his harsh words bled over to B's like a contagion. Bled over to B like a contagion. Okay. Wait, said B suddenly. Did someone just say contagion? Oh, I did. Oh. Yes, I believe so. What of it? Well, that villager told us to watch out for contagious words, right? The mare leaned forward with renewed interest, pushing a startled vice aside in the process. He must have said something, right? Asked the mare. Some specific combination of words? What was it? It was about dreaming, or something that dreams, or... Oh, what the hell was it? A sheep? Cried Vice suddenly, blurting out the first thing that popped into his head. Into this head? His head? Huh. The others stared at him for a moment before slowly shaking their heads. After a few more minutes of thought, B's face suddenly lit up. I remember, he said, those who dream. That's what he said, I'm sure of it. At this, the mare produced a thick sheaf. I feel like this type, is sheaf a word? Like this, in this context anyway? A thick sheaf of papers from his pocket. He flipped through them a few times before finally nodding his approval at B. I don't know that word, so. That sounds right, he said, as a stray sheet of paper fluttered to the ground. My notes also mentioned something about that. I bet it was the last thing you heard before you fell asleep. The mayor shook his head, his worn pencil stub tracing lines across a lone piece of paper. For the last month, I've done nothing but study the disease we call the Death Dream, he said. I mean, I'm the mayor, right? It's my job to protect people from whatever comes along. But I never expected a couple of outsiders to start entering people's dreams. The mayor paused, a grimace crossing his face. I should probably be taking notes or something. Vice immediately fired back. I applaud the force of will it takes to research a disease in your dreams, he said. But perhaps you should bend your efforts to escaping this place instead of trying to understand it. The mayor's hand tightened around his pencil, snapping off the tip. I tried to escape. From the very first moment I realized I was locked inside my own dream, I've been looking for a way out. But I don't think it exists. I mean, this is my dream, right? If there was an exit, I'd know about it. He paused for a moment, his unfocused eyes staring at nothing. My village was beautiful, he said to no one in particular, and it was filled with the most wonderful people you could ever hope to meet. But once this disease took hold, things changed. It's like someone took a sponge and soaked all the color out of our lives. I just want us to be whole again. I want us to be free. And I won't stop trying until it happens. B nodded in agreement. Huh? Wait a second. I didn't nod? Look, if we can be of any help, said B, just ask. Lots of bees in there. Now hold on, I did not just say that. Who's saying this? Is that me or is that... MC? I'm so confused. Silence, cried Vice. The grimoire looked from B to the mayor and back again, his face filling with confidence. Grimoire Vice's face is always confident, thank you very much. Now see here, mayor. You told us that nothing can exist in this dream without your knowing of it. But yet you seemed surprised to see us when we first arrived, yes? The mayor slowly raised his head, realization dawning on his face. Oh my god, he said. You're right! I had no idea you were coming! The human imagination is a limitless engine, said Vice, and dreams are the fuel. If you can imagine an exit, then it must be so. With your permission, we shall search it out. Thank you, said the mayor. I don't know how I can repay you. Payment is not required. We're as eager as you to be done with this place. The mayor suddenly felt as if he could breathe again. He'd almost forgotten what it was like. Good luck, you two, he called out the departing forms of B and Vice. We're all counting on you. As B slowly faded into the misty forest, the mayor was struck by a sense of deja vu. I saw this man once before, he thought. But where? B's mood darkened as he trudged through the forest. Hours earlier, when the beauty of the place was still a new thing, he'd been confident they could get in, find the exit, and be home in time for dinner. But the deeper they went, the more the forest closed in around him. The mist made it difficult to see more than a foot in any direction, and moss-covered rocks seemed determined to twist his ankle. More than once, he'd been forced to steady himself on the rough bark of a tree, and his hands now left small trails of blood on everything he touched. Additionally, Vice was proven to be a spectacularly poor traveling companion. Unhindered by either terrain or physical effort, he spent most of his time urging B to pick up the pace and grumbling about their slow progress. Finally, after Vice muttered something about legless turtles being more adept at navigating the environment, B snapped. "Okay, Vice, cram it for a second, would you? You don't have to walk." B leaned against a tree and tried to stretch the knots from his back. "How can the stupid forest be so big?" he muttered to himself. The moment the words trembled from his mouth, a cacophony of insects sprang to life. Every imaginable form of buzz, click, and hiss roared out at a volume that rattled his teeth. B slapped his hands over his ears and screamed to be heard. "Vice, what's going on?" B could see Vice's mouth moving, but he might as well have been shouting in a tornado. The insects screamed, the forest howled. And then, just as B's ears seemed ready to tear from his head and go running for cover, the sound diminished. Hesitantly, he removed the hand from his left ear and listened to the creatures of the woods. "Zuri! Zuri! Zuri!" I have no idea what sound this is supposed to sound like. VN time. It is, but it's really... I like it a lot. This part's cool. Shock! Shock! I'm an insect. Woo-woo-woo-ma! Woo-woo-woo-ma! Whoa, what is this sound? Shik-shik-seek! Shik-shik-shik-shik-seek! As the insect's symphony dimmed another decibel, B began to detect patterns in the sound. This isn't random, he thought. It's not just white noise. It's something else. Top-tier voice acting. I know. What can I say? The insects weren't just calling out. They were asking a question. One with it is lacking. Two with it is ideal. Three with it is dangerous. What is it? One is lacking. Two is ideal. Three is dangerous. Oh, that's interesting. I don't know this. Puzzles? Riddles in my VN? Be my pages. Is this a riddle? Or by my pages, is this a riddle? I guess so. I mean, it feels sort of forced, but maybe it's the key to getting out of this place. And I leave it to you to answer. One with it is lacking. Two with it is ideal. Three with it is dangerous. What is it? The answer is a secret. The answer is a seesaw. How should I know? Okay. I mean, is the answer a seesaw? It sounds too dank. I mean, but it kind of makes sense. I don't know. Seesaw is the funniest. I think it actually makes sense, kind of, too. Like, it's like the least philosophical thing. Why is the music so tense? Alright, it's a seesaw. Something that's ideal with two people, but dangerous with three. Oh, it's a seesaw. Vice's mouth flew open, but before he could say anything, the world suddenly shifted. Reen, reen, wah! Reen, reen, wah! Chick-chick-key! Chick-chick-key! When B came to, he was once again surrounded by the sounds of insects. The cries of the insects were creating words. Words he had heard somewhere before. One with it is lacking. Two with it is ideal. Three with it is dangerous. What is it? Vice opened his mouth as if to say, "You buffoon." How should I know? Bryce's mouth blew open, but before he could say anything, the words suddenly shifted. Oops. Wait, do I need to refresh my chat to see noted? There we go. I like noted. Thank you. Get that mouse out of here. When B came to here, he was once again surrounded by the sounds of insects. I guess the answer is a secret. Inwardly furious that Vice left the task to him, B sighed and gave the only answer that made sense. Why is two ideal? I don't know, because sharing a secret is fun with someone? I mean, it's not that much more dangerous than with three, or less dangerous than with three. It's a secret. Right? The sound of the insects stopped as suddenly as it began. The forest undergrowth parted before B like a rippling wave, opening a new path. These forest arthropods are making a road for us, said Vice with glee. Pleased at passing the test, B moved on with new intensity, with new determination. The path offered his body relief from the undergrowth, but gave even greater cheer to his mind. As long as they were on a path, their journey had a purpose. I guess the forest has accepted us, huh? Said B after a bit. Vice spun around to face his companion. Do not mistake the will of this voice for some happy pet you can suddenly befriend. We have no idea where this path leads. As Vice finished speaking, the pair turned a corner and found themselves facing a clear forest spring, smiling. B picked up a small rock and sent it skipping across the surface of the water. I love skipping rocks. This is pretty accurate. Good heavens, said Vice. His surprise was understandable. Each time the rock struck the surface of the water, a musical note rang out. Oh! When the rock finally stopped moving and sank to the bottom of the spring, the ripples it left behind came together to form words. I enter through the window, but break no glass. When night falls, I vanish. What am I? Is that not just like the sun or something? The sun or light or something? Absurdly easy, barked Vice. Now answer it. B grit his teeth and tried not to reach out and strangle his companion. He's right after all. This one is pretty easy. I enter through the window, but break no glass. When night falls, I vanish. What am I? Alright, I'm gonna say it. Hey, Cat, good morning. How are you? How's the Minecraft been? Have you died? I hope it's been fun. Sunlight. We're in VN mode for this game, apparently. It's just all reading. A plume of water suddenly burst from the spring. Sunlight filtered through the trees and reflected off the plume, creating a shimmering rainbow that spanned the entire horizon. In all my years, said Vice softly, I have never seen such a sight. Perhaps I have misunderstood the intentions of this place. Hey, look, cried B, awakening Vice from his daze. There's a house or something over there. You did not die yet, but Minecraft is super fun. Good, nice. What's the goal? What's the goal of your hardcore mode? I don't know the objective. Glancing in the direction of his friend's extended hand, Vice saw a small cottage nestled among the trees. That's weird, isn't it, Vice? I mean, who would build a house all the way out here? B walked over and pounded on the door. After a minute of solid banging, the door cracked open and a small man peered out. His body was cloaked from neck to toe in a large black cape, while his face was obscured by mist. Began B. But before he could get any further, the cloaked man held a hand up and began speaking. I have four legs and... Oh. This is man, right? No. Yeah, this is man, a human. I have 4 legs in the morning and 2 at night, or 2 at noon, but end the night with 3. What am I? He tried to ask the cloaked man who he was and what he was doing there, but he simply repeated the question. If we wish to engage this man in conversation, said Vice, it seems we must answer his riddle. Yeah, I suppose, said B. Well, at least it's an easy one. I have 4 legs in the morning and 2 at noon, but end the night with 3. What am I? A man, a demon, an angel. His name is Karlor. He has the wings of like an angel, but also that of a demon. To beat the Ender Dragon, get an Elytra. Basically do all the hard stuff in the game. Gotcha. Oh, Jordan, of course you knew. Because you thought it too. It's only because of these two words. Like, anything that has both demon and angel in the same, like, screen, I'm gonna think of that stupid video. Oh, man. How long would all that take, typically, Kat? I know maybe you're gonna play it even safer in this mode, so maybe, like, and you're streaming, obviously, so maybe add, like, more than double the time you would think it'd normally take. I don't know. And he has, and he will. The mist dissolved from the cloaked figure as he spoke a single word. Correct. With that, the man flung his garment aside, revealing his true identity. You're the mayor, cried B. Why was the mayor quizzing me? The small man slowly shook his head. I am not the mayor you know. Now listen to my words. Long ago, I saw a version of you that was not yourself. Sorry, what's that mean? Oh! This is the first time this entire dialogue sequence that my camera is cutting off any words. And it was, like, so close multiple times with that line, one of the lines being right above my camera, but this is the first time it's gone this far below. You hate to see it. They didn't account for it. You still want to goof off in the game and build a base. You're going to take your time. If you're guarded, you could probably get there in another stream or two. Gotcha. Nice. But it's fun to grind and, like, it's fun to goof off and get stronger and take it slow. And then the game's not so hard. And then you feel stronger. It will make sense in time. At present, I simply congratulate you on cracking the seal of the Death Dream. Now you must go to the person at the forest entrance. Who needs words with this VA work? Right. With that, the man turned on his heel and slammed the door behind him. As B watched, mist seeped up from the ground and enveloped the cottage, erasing it from existence. When B and Vice returned to the forest entrance, they found the mayor leaning against a tree. As soon as he caught sight of the duo, he sprang to his feet and scrambled over to them. Good gravy, he cried. You made it. You actually made it back. His left hand grasped B's and pumped it so fiercely it threatened to dislodge from the socket, while his right seized Vice by the cover and swung him through the air. Oh, I'm sure Vice hates that. Well, B is in this game. Yeah, I didn't know that, I was gonna have to, like... I feel like... The interesting thing is that this part has a narrator, which is me. Like, me the player. But the characters also have acknowledged the narrator. So I thought that's so... It's kind of fourth wall. It's kind of interesting. Kind of cool. Gah! By the heavens, stop shaking me, fool! We have not even told you if we were successful or not. The mayor smiled broadly and shook his head. I'm just happy you're alive. I didn't think I'd ever see you again. B withdrew himself from the mayor's eager handshake with a slight smile. We broke the Death Dream seal, he said. At least, I think we did. The mayor's face beamed as Bee filled him in on the details. When the tale was done, the three of them laid down on the forest ground and fell asleep. Bee cocked his head. Okay, hang on a second. This is crazy. Why don't we just lay down and go to sleep? Seize your endless prattle and go to sleep, fool. Fighting against the rules of this place is futility itself. Bee and the mare obediently reclined atop the grassy earth. Have you forgotten, continued Vice? It is words that control the death dream. Words that allow us to move from place to place. No matter how unnatural they seem, the words are absolute. Therefore, if the words tell us to sleep, then sleep we shall. And once we do, the story will continue. Oh, another cutoff. With that, the trio found their eyes growing heavy, their breath slowing. This is the first time, began the mayor, the first time I have felt tired since I was imprisoned here. His words were cut off by a loud, long yawn, and he remembered nothing more. They might have slept for an hour or a year. When they awoke, things had slightly more real quality to them. The mist felt thicker, the leaves greener. It was clear that they had awakened from their dream. Bee shook the mare's shoulder gently. Good news, he said. I think we made it. Oh, wow, said the mare in an odd voice. We did. I'm back. He blinked once and then again, as if not quite believing the sight before him. You two have no idea how much this means. The death dream was spreading through our village, and I wanted to. Well, I thought I could figure out how to stop it, but I guess that wasn't the case. I must have caught the disease and become trapped in my own dream. The mayor started to stand, then collapsed back to the earth. He stared at his legs as if trying to remember how they worked, then glanced at Bee and shrugged. Without a word, the young man reached out and pulled the mayor to his feet. Real life may take some getting used to, said the mayor, as a wry smile crossed his lips. He shall relearn in short order, I am sure, said Vice. For now, you should return to your home and rest. No, said the mayor, swaying on unsteady feet. No, I can't. Some of the villagers are still trapped in the death dream. I have to save them. The mayor slowly made his way to the divine tree in the center of the village, then bowed his head and prayed silently. This is a holy tree, he explained when the prayer was finished. It's the guardian of our village's history and memories. Superstition will only make our mission harder, muttered Vice. We should not put our faith in the gods. I need to take a drink. Whew. The mayor shook his head. Not the gods, the words. Legend says that our tree is home to a powerful magic known as a sealed verse. Bee and Vice could not contain their surprise. It seemed the goal had been found in the most unexpected of places. Skeletor voice. And he prays. And he prays.
Oh my god, do I pray?
Oh, what a good... Man, that video... just, like, was so popular at such a random time. I say, muttered Vice, this is certainly a stroke of luck. As the three of them said their goodbyes, Bee mentioned the strange man who had given them the third riddle and the mysterious words he had left with them. I once saw a version of you that was not yourself, muttered the mayor. What in the world does that mean? Lost in thought, he stared into space for a long moment. You know, he said softly, it's going to sound odd, but I had a feeling I'd seen you before, too. Well, he did think that earlier. Bee tried to keep a straight face and failed, but the mayor didn't seem to notice. Deja vu, right? Anyway, I figure it's just some kind of illusion created by the death dream. It probably doesn't mean anything. Uh-huh. Bee gave the mayor a nod and a smile, but inwardly his thoughts were racing. There's something wrong about the mayor and his words. And what exactly is going on here? That riddle would prove to be the most difficult one of all.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you for voice acting. That isn't mine, so I don't have to read everything. Hey, what's up, Josh? How are you? Good morning.
Now I can finally return to a normal life.
This is one of the most bizarre diseases I have ever encountered.
I know. That's why we have to help the other villagers, no matter what.
Obtain a sealed burst. Obtain dark execution magic. Summon magical spikes from the ground to impale enemies. Charge increase the number of spikes. Ooh.
For a sealed burst, that didn't take much effort.
Yes, all a touch too.
Good, just chilling. How's this game? This game is sick. Have you played Automata? Or Automata? I don't know how you pronounce it. It's very different, but they're both good. And this is a prequel. Oh, you did play it. Okay. Yeah, I like this game a lot so far. I like the combat a lot more than Automata so far. And it's definitely different. Like, as far as I know. So, I came into this game assuming that my main character was an android, right? Just like 2B. But no, this character I think is human. I don't know enough. Maybe he's human. But it seems human. All a touch too easy, if you ask me.
It's almost as if someone was guiding us to this village.
Vaguely human.
Don't overthink advice.
But yeah, okay. How do I equip things again? Okay. Dark execution. Whoa, that's cool. That used so much mana. I'll try it out. Okay, gotta keep this one. This is just like the classic. One thing I don't like, I like this game over Automata is that in Automata you have your pod and you're basically always shooting with your pod because there's literally no reason not to. But in this game you don't have to do that. This is kind of nice not having to do that. So these villagers are stuck in their dreams. They're stuck in the death dream.
This person must be dreaming too.
It would appear that way, yes.
End of this villager's dream. Oh, wait, is this Psychonauts? Are we playing Psychonauts?
Can't say I'm very excited to go back there. That dream world sort of creeps me out.
Wait, am I reading? You thought this was legit a VN. It still might be a VN. This might not be over.
Perhaps you should spend less time complaining and more time getting on with the mission.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. Alright, VN time. Super VN time, I guess. I breathe air, scented with death, and resist the urge to laugh. For I know it will sound like the words of a madman. How long have I been in this fresh hell? My box, my prison, is tucked beneath a stairway in the long unused catacombs of some infinite castle. Outside, I hear the sounds of a funeral dirge that plays without end. Light has no place here. Wind is a forgotten friend. I pray for death to come, but he forsakes me. Time passes, and eternity slips by in a single tick of the clock. Someone knocks on my prison. Anyone there? I hear an unfamiliar voice say. My savior. I claw at the door of my jail, embedding thick splinters under my ragged nails. I scream for help. I laugh. I sob. Surely this is a product of my addled mind. Surely it cannot be true. So, the first person in here, I think it's a dreamer, right? I mean, that seems to make sense. That, like, the unfamiliar voice is my voice, B's voice. So, the first is probably, yeah, I think that's right. Help me, I cry, for the love of all the gods, help me. Impossibly, I hear the sound of a lock being torn out and fall into the floor. As the door slowly creaks open, I have just enough time to see a silver-haired boy and a floating book before the light pours inside. Confirmed, okay. My eyes, accustomed to blackness, explode with pain, and I am forced to turn away. Who are you? I ask, shaking hands, covering my face. How have you come to this place? I am Grimoire Vice, and this is B. Long have we been searching for you. Now come, stand. We shall awaken from this nightmare together. The one known as B extends his hand and pulls me from the cell. Though my eyes are slow to adjust to freedom, my ears are keen as ever, and they recognize this. Staccato. Sounds of heavy rain. I never thought to hear that again, I whisper. This were not such a terrible storm, said Grimoire Vice. Look at your feet. I force my eyes open and see water pooling around my ankles and lapping at my shins. There's so much of it. Yes, and more comes each moment we delay. If we do not make good our escape, we shall all drown in this castle. We know you are weak. We are our only hope to survive this place. Staccato. Oh. Are you sure you're not trying to say Sokotoa? Time, that long forgotten friend, made itself known again. I nodded my head and swore to save my rescuers, no matter the cost. The castle catacombs are a maze, twisting upon themselves like the endless entrails of a giant. Ooh, I like this. I like this a lot. This is so good. I squint down the dim corridors and proceed north. Oh, I was like, what is it waiting for? At the end of the corridor, I find a row of 20 gorgeous canopied beds resting atop a carpet of velvet. All are covered in a thick layer of dust and cobwebs. Searching for the door to the next room, I come upon a shapeless mass of gray matter. It has been shoved against the side of the wall, and despite my fever, I think I see the outlines of a door just beyond. When I reach out a finger and touch a piece of the mass, it turns to dust and drifts away on the wind. Realization slowly dawns. I fall to my knees and weep. Corpses. I face a mountain of charred and crumbling corpses. Oh, dang. I look from it to the beds and back again until the horror dawns full upon me. Someone has piled these bodies into a tower and set them ablaze. Whether they are alive or dead, I do not know. The sanity will not permit me to consider the proposition further. I make a sound, whether scream or laughter, I cannot be certain. Then my mind grants me merciful blackness, and I find myself opening the door and leaving that most terrible of rooms. I squint down the dim corridors and proceed east or south. Why would I go south? It kind of depends on what direction the door was facing. I mean, the door, I was going north and I got into the room. If the door's at the other end of the north room, then going south is literally just going backwards. Let's go east. I squint down the door corridors and proceed. I went east, now let's go north. I squint down the dim corridors and go west. At the end of the path, a row of heavy wooden casks lie on their sides in a dark chamber. Doubtless they are filled with wine. My thirst roars to life. I could not remember the last time my parched throat had relief. I scramble to the first cask and pull frantically at the cork. The theft of a few cups means nothing, I tell myself. The casks will be ruined by the flood regardless. Finally, the cork surrenders to my attack, and thick red liquid bursts forth from the hole. This is no wine. This is no wine. It is blood, still warm from the body. Whether animal or something else, I cannot say. The foul liquid soon mixes with the rising flood waters. creating a warmth that laps against my thighs. Dang. By all the gods, are the rest of these casts filled with blood as well? I lack the courage to confirm my suspicion. Disgust quickly becomes fear as I turn to flee, but my weakened legs betray me, sending me toppling over into the red ocean below. You need an adult. I love this. This is so cool. Like, man, I like the writing like a lot. I think it's so neat. The smell of death is everywhere. It threatened to consume me. I must escape this hell. Crawling on all fours like an animal. Sorry, something's going on my, like, I feel like I'm kind of nasally. Do you guys hear that? Or is that just me? Crawling on all fours like an animal, holding back screams lest any foulness enter my mouth. I lurch forward, through the red waters and out of the room, to freedom. Allergies have been killing you this week too? I don't know. Is it allergies? Maybe it is. I didn't even consider it. I feel like allergies don't really affect me that much, but maybe I've just never known. But I'd believe it. Okay. Out of the room to freedom. Okay. So right now. Wait. Question. Maybe this is... You don't need to answer this necessarily. No, that's a dumb question. Never mind, I'm not asking it. It's stupid. That's really dumb. You're dying to allergies right now, too? Dang. Yeah, it's brutal. But spring is upon us, so it'll be feeling good pretty soon. I squint down the dim corridors and proceed. East? Let's go east again. At the end of the path, I find myself in a gray hall with only the sounds of rain for comfort. The waterlogged red carpet squishes beneath my feet as I approach the center of the room. Once there, I behold a beautiful dining table, upon which rests china and silver of the finest construction, as well as the remains of a fantastic feast. As my eyes continue to adjust, I see many chairs surrounding the table, each holding a dinner guest. Noticing movement, I approach the chair at the table's head, but as the truth of the matter dawns on me, I recoil in horror. The host of the feast is a corpse, as are all the invited guests. An army of fowl, wriggling insects have made homes in their remains, and this is the movement I saw. This once splendid feast was now nothing more than a requiem for the damned. I take a moment to steady my shaking hands, then slowly back away from the table. Hey, Pipe, how are ya? You arrived at a questionable time. Hope you're doing well, though. I take a moment to steady my shaking hands, then slowly back away from the table. Desperate to lose sight of the abomination before me, my gaze lands on the chairs upon which the dead were seated. This is a mistake. For the chairs proved to be even more terrible than the feast itself. Each one is covered in a layer of spikes that run from the seat, up the back, and down the arms. This sounds like the worst chair in the world. It was, well, how am I? I'm good. So my birthday was on Monday, but last night I celebrated with my family because my parents were in Puerto Rico during my actual birthday. And it was nice because on my actual birthday, I got to just spend time with, like, friends and, like, other people. And my, well, some friends and my girlfriend. Well, mostly, like, my church friends. And then And then Friday, my family. So I just got to, like, separate it out. Didn't have to, like, split my time between them, I guess, on the same day. So it was good. Okay. This explains the color of the carpet beneath my feet. I could only pray that the unfortunate diners were dead when the meal began. For if not, it is a simple task to envision the agonized screams that must have sprung forth from their mouths. My mind grasps frantically at the possibility that these souls had committed some terrible crime for which this was punishment. Though in truth, I suspect they had committed no crime at all. There would be no tomorrow for these unfortunates. This was their last supper. What's happening? So, I mean, you've seen like a decent amount of this game. So now we're in this area where people are stuck in their dreams. And so we're entering our, like, the main character in Vice, B in Vice, we're entering the dreams to try and free them from their dreams. And it's really cool, I think. I like it a lot. And the dreams are basically like VN style, obviously. A lot of reading. Kind of like choose your own adventure. And the I in these scenarios are the dreamer. The people we're trying to free from the dream. So this person's dream, he was stuck in a prison, and then B and Vice, the MC, we come to free him from the prison, and then now we're trying to escape he's in a prison in a castle, and now we're trying to escape the castle, and every room we enter is kind of like a horror in itself, and it's really neat so far. I think all these dreams are going to be different. It kind of reminds me of SpongeBob. When SpongeBob's just entering all their dreams. Alright, so we just went east. So if we go west, we'll go back to the way we came. Well, we can head north. Let's try and head north. Against all hope, we make it to the front door. Oh, break it down, someone cries. And so I give myself to the effort. In tandem with B and Grimoire Vice, I slam my body against the thick, sturdy door. On the third try, it gives way, and we find ourselves sprawled on the ground outside the castle. The storm is in retreat. The clouds above are still dark and foreboding. But to the west, I can see a thin shimmer of sunlight trying to break through. How can I thank you, I cry, as tears join the rain on my cheeks. I would surely have died in there. Looking down, I suddenly notice that my dress is... Oh, sorry. This is probably a woman. I thought it was a man. Looking down, I suddenly notice that my dress is in tatters and sheepishly try to cover my exposed skin. It could be a man, but it's probably a woman. Sheepishly try to cover my exposed skin. Your dress? Asks Vice. Then you are a woman, madam? I am. I proffer the two a smile. I suppose that comes as something of a surprise, seeing as how I exist only in the form of words. I can see that the one known as B is disappointed that the torn dress will be given no further description, but he hides it well. With a nod and a shrug, the three of us set forth to our awakening. But behind us, an awakening of another kind is taking place. Like, this is from inside the castle? First pronunciation was right. Proffer. Gotcha. Black smoke fills the abandoned castle, providing the countless damned souls inside with their final shroud. After a moment, the castle's windows shatter with a mighty roar. A fresh breeze blows through the hallways and corridors, clearing the smoke away for good. As we watch in awe, uncountable black shadows slowly flicker to life, crossing to and fro in front of the broken windows. The castle's dead have awakened to their new life as shades.
You have anything to say about that?
Hopefully there will be no labyrinth next time.
I hear that.
Okay.
Thank you so much for saving me.
You're welcome.
I never want to have a dream like that again.
That was a very scary dream. That's wild. Okay. So we freed the mayor, this woman. Now I take a little break. Because, well, I've been reading a lot, and my voice is could use a little rest, so I'm gonna take a quick break. Just like go to the bathroom and stuff. The reading is murder? Yeah, it is a lot. My man streamer ain't what he used to be. I've really fallen off. I mean, I'm definitely not used to reading this much out loud anymore. I haven't shown this yet to most people, actually. I posted it. It's in Mickey's Discord because I talked about it in her stream and someone like wanted to see it. But this is what Megan got me for my birthday. I thought it was really pretty neat, actually. If you guys, some of you guys might know what it is. It is it's just a clock, but it's Captain Falcon. And it's all his aerials. So, pretty neat. She was like, you need a clock. But yeah, it's pretty cool. I think it's really neat. Alright. Okay, let's do the next stream. And another big reading time. That's okay. I really like these dreams. I think they're well written. I think, and I think, like, It really gets the imagination going. See this one.
And another victim. This work certainly is trying.
Enter the villager's dream.
I figured a book like you would be into all this word stuff, Vice.
Even I have my exceptions. Now let's be off.
I don't really know how we enter the dreams. I think we did. Oh, yeah, we say a phrase. I wish I'd say it. A colony of massive sculptures was visible in the distance, their tall forms scraping against the sky. Vice and Bee had never seen such a sight, and their eyes widened as they tried to take it in.
Those buildings must be huge if we can see them from this far away.
Oh, we got some voice in here again. Nice. We had some voice in the first dream.
What do you think, Vice?
As Vice considered his answer, the sun beat down on them with renewed ferocity.
Perhaps they are some manner of mirage.
Under this heat, a mirage or two would hardly be an unexpected sight. Bee nodded and wiped the sweat off his brow, leaving a trail of sand in its place. He thought he'd never been so thirsty. The ancient road on which they walked was black and cracked with age. Here and there, thin wisps of grass pushed up through the rocky surface, as if to find those who had laid this material down over their home. The heat reflecting from the road made Bee lightheaded. His feet hurting, he crashed down to rest. I don't know how much longer I can do this. Is someone playing a joke on us or what? The complaining had already begun. Vice tried not to let his eyes roll too much. A joke, he said? No, no joke. This road leads to the City of Art. Perhaps the path itself is simply some manner of grand artistic work. You don't sound very sure of yourself there. Perhaps not, but thinking of it in this way might make it easier for you to bear. Bee glanced at Vice's grinning face, shook his head, and resumed walking. As time passed, Bee's feet grew more painful, and his throat drier than he thought possible. He tried not to look further than the next step ahead, because the bright sunlight made him hesitant to trust his own senses. We are definitely getting closer, said Vice, in an effort to cheer his companion. Yes, this much is certain. Encouraged, Bee lifted his gaze. Suddenly, he stopped walking, choosing instead to stand in the middle of the road with his mouth and eyes wide open and his finger pointed in the distance. Water, he cried. It's water! Water? Asked Vice. Preposterous. I don't see any water. Over there, just ahead of us. Look, the sun is reflecting off it. Without waiting for a response, V sprang to life and bounded toward the sight. It's a mirage, right? There is no water. There's nothing but sand in every direction. Bee closed his eyes and sighed as Vice floated up behind him and chuckled softly. I believe this is known as a mirage, he said. Many a desert traveler have spoken of such things. Bee shook his head, bewildered. Suddenly, he pointed off in the distance, his eyes wide once more. Wait, there it is. I just missed it. Look, it's right there. Is he coping? Bee sprinted off again, leaving Vice with no choice but to follow. After a few minutes of running, Bee came to a halt. I could have sworn it was right here. Confused, he put his hands up to his eyes and rubbed them vigorously. As soon as he stopped, he noticed a blue shimmering pool of clear water just over the next rise. With a shout, he bounded up and searched for it. Oh man. God, this is just Silksong fans. Every time anything happens related to Hollow Knight or anything, this is just Silksong fans. People are still coping, and people think that something, they're gonna get an announcement soon. That's what people are thinking. I've watched a lot of videos recently about it. The chase continued for nearly an hour, with an exasperated Vice finally floated up to Bee and struck him in the face with his cover. Enough, you blithering idiot. Stop this at once. There is no water here. B's face clouded. There isn't? There is not. Perhaps next time you'll listen to me when I tell you as much. Vice paused for a moment, then continued speaking in a slightly kinder tone. However, I suppose this mad chase was not altogether wasted. It seems we have arrived in the City of Art. B looked up. Stretched out before him was a row of impossibly tall structures. Their journey was at an end. They're huge, cried B, completely forgetting the heat and pain of the past few hours. I've never seen anything so big. Each sculpture was formed from roughly the same shape, a tall rectangle that stretched up toward the sky, but that is where the similarities ended. Most are covered with panes of glass that reflected light in a thousand directions, while others seemed to be nothing but frames of steel. Some had tall spires on their tops, while others possessed triangular caps. Spires? Related. Alright, I have to check this tweet now. Hollow Knight fans of the guest store page with no release date and no other new information.
Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn and run. It's time to do what must be done. Be a king of kingdom come. So you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody.
This is all just different. This is like a little compilation, right? Different cutscenes from Yakuza. That's so funny. It's so true though. Hollow Knight fans just go ham on anything. The Xbox showcase in June is totally gonna have Silk Song Copium. Yakuza is so good. Have you, you guys have just played the newer ones, right? Or Pipe, have you played the older ones too? Some had tall spires on their tops, while others possessed triangular caps, okay? What kind of city is this, said B. Where are the people? Where are the houses? You haven't played the newest one yet, gotcha. Perhaps the land is intended exclusively for artistic use. The debate continued as they made their way through the city. Miracles of artistry were everywhere. Great iron crates with wheels sat silent on steel rails. Beautifully carved works with lights of red, amber, and green dangled over every street. As they moved away from the massive sculptures, they found a great array of smaller ones. Some were covered in glass or brick, but many were composed of materials that they had never before encountered. The sheer variety of colors and styles was staggering. You've only played Judgment, Lost Judgment, and a few hours of Yakuza 0. Barely any mainline. Oh, gotcha. Oh, those are all spin-offs? Is it... the mainline ones are the beat-em-up style, right? And then the spin-offs are the more RPG style? Is that right? Unable to find a theme or purpose to the abstract works around them, B and Vice eventually fell silent. On the outskirts of the city, they discovered three sculptures in the shape of humans. B uttered a sigh of relief as he approached them. Finally, I was getting tired of modern art. The three statues were indistinguishable, except for a single word chiseled into their right arms. One read Alpha, one read Beta, and the final one read Gamma. Zero isn't a spin-off, but Judgments are. The RPG ones aren't spin-offs either. That's where they're taking the main game. Oh, gotcha! 7 and 8 are sort of trend-based RPGs. I see. I like that better. Personally, but I mean, that's just like my style of game more than beat 'em ups. As someone who has never played a Yakuza game. As B moved to touch the nearest statue, a bird flew from the top of one of the sculptures, alighting on the statue's shoulder. It emitted a brief, beautiful song that took the form of words. Seven is a great place to start if you want to get into Yakuza. Gotcha. Only one form is real, the others are false. Ooh! The real form will always speak the truth. Oh no, I'm so bad at this. And then one will always, the real form will always speak the truth and the others will always tell a lie. The false ones will only speak lies. With that, the bird departed, as if on cue. The three statues shuddered to life, acquiring color and form as they began to breathe. Hey, look at that, said B. They're alive. I forget this puzzle. I don't remember what to ask them to know which is true. You really want to play 7 once you get a PS5. The world of Yakuza is super fun. You just get bored by beat-em-ups. Yeah, I'm not a fan of beat-em-ups. The world of Yakuza seems kind of silly, in a good way. Like, there's so much random stuff to do. You need to, like, become, like, a business person. A tycoon. The triplets bowed low before B. Please, said Alpha. You have to get me out of this nightmare. I am real. Stop lying, said Beta. He turned to B and threw his hands in the air. Alpha's a fake, you know. I'm the real one. What a load of crap, said Gamma. Beta is a fake. Everyone knows I'm the only one. I'm the only real one around here. So no one has said anything about Gamma here. The respective pleas given, the three statues returned to their frozen state as silence once again enveloped the city. When you consider all the statements, only one of them could be the real thing, said Vice. B furrowed his eyebrows and considered his answer. Okay, hang on. Wait, I need to know what they said again. So I am the real one. The others are fake. That's what Alpha says. Where's Ligma, am I right? I don't know what Ligma means other than the meme. Alpha is fake. I am the real one. And then Gamma says Beta is fake. I am the real one. That's all it means. Okay, gotcha. The real one is Gamma. So if Alpha is telling the truth, then Gamma is lying, is partially telling the truth by saying that Beta is fake. So Alpha can't be real, is the real one. If Beta is the real one, then Alpha says, I'm the real one, the others are fake. That is... that's false. I need to remember what they say. I think it's Gamma. I think Gamma's the real one, though. I think it's Gamma. The real one is Gamma. The eyes of the statue shone with an eerie light. The light grew stronger and stronger until B and Vice were forced to turn away. Oh, I'm insane. Getting jump scared by an ACT question.
It would seem we...
Oh no, I was wrong! No!
Yeah.
We'd best act more carefully next time.
This is the worst job ever.
And another victim. This work certainly is trying.
I figured a book like you would be into...
Even I...
Alright, Casket. Oh, man.
What are you...
Okay, hang on. We're almost there. Alright, I need to read what they say again here. Oh! Okay, let's read these again. Okay. So Alpha only says I am real. He says nothing about the others. Okay, so let's do this again. Alpha's real, then that's fine. I mean, that's fine. He just, like, didn't say anything about anyone else. And then Beta, if Beta's telling the truth, that would mean Alpha is a fake, and so Alpha is not real, so that's confirmed. Then Beta says Alpha's a fake, which would be true, and I'm the real one. Which would also be true then. And the Gamma says the Beta's a fake, which is false. Everyone knows I'm the only real one around here, which is also false. Okay, so Beta's make sense, right? Unless, oh man, okay. Alright, if Gamma's real, oh, okay, yeah. If Gamma's real, then Beta is saying Alpha's a fake, which is true. So that can't. So it seems like Beta has to be the answer, right? Yeah, because if Alpha's real, then Gamma can't say Beta's a fake. Yeah. The real one is Beta. Though B's voice betrayed a notable lack of confidence, he was relieved to see Vice nodding at him. If Alpha were telling the truth, began Vice in the dry tones of a lecturer, Beta and Gamma would be fakes, but in that case, Gamma's claim that Beta is fake would be the truth, even though Gamma is a liar. Therefore, that theory crumbles. Now let's presume that Gamma spoke the truth. That makes Alpha and Beta liars. In this situation, however, Beta is calling Alpha a liar, which would leave us with two statues telling the truth. Finally, let us assume that Beta is telling the truth. If so, Alpha and Gamma's lies would make sense, therefore Beta must be real. As Vice finished his explanation, Alpha and Gamma crumbled soundlessly into dust, while Beta sprang to life once more. As brute forced it. Is brute force the best way to do that puzzle? Sounds like it probably is. I don't know. Congratulations, villagers, said Vice in a cheerful voice. The time to awaken has arrived. Thank you for saving me, cried the villager. He dropped to his knees and bowed his head as low as it could go before an uncomfortable bee pulled him to his feet. Why'd you have a dream like this? Asked Vice. Have you been to the city before? The villager slowly looked around at the bizarre objects and sculptures that dotted the landscape and shook his head. I don't think so. I mean, it's impossible, right? There's no way I could have ever been to a place like this. But at the same time, I feel like I've seen it before. Deja vu, muttered B, just like the mayor. The vague sense of unease that struck B during the mayor's dream spread once more through his mind.
That was rough.
I am positive I have seen that place before.
Okay, that's enough. Don't need you getting all weird on me, too. Okay, there. Now all the villagers can wake up, right?
Yes, if the mayor's assumption was correct.
So there's only two villagers? Not a very big village. Can you even call it a village?
I think I have had enough wordplay to last a lifetime. Thank you very much.
You're telling me. Anyway, let's go see the mayor.
Okay.
Oh, how wonderful. Thank you so much. Here, I have something for you.
Obtain the one-handed sword Fade. Oh,
wow,
nice.
This looks valuable. I can really have it?
Of course. It's apparently a weapon of some renown. But we have little use for it.
Well, we appreciate it.
Thank you again for everything.
Oh, dang. This thing's a monster. This thing's a beast. Word edits. How do I equip best words again? Pahama, obviously. Need broken antennas for this to upgrade it. I could upgrade it pretty soon, I think. A sword carried by the world's most loyal servant. Like that loyalty, the sword's blade is straight and true. Wow, each weapon has a story? Did you read all those, Jordan? That's kind of cool. I'm gonna save, and I need to go to the bathroom again. Even though it hasn't been even that long. So I'm just too hydrated right now. Alright, I'll be right back. Okay. Alright. Are we done here? I think we're done with the Forest of Myth. This is a really cool area. I like this place a lot. I mean, between like the environment itself and then also what you had to do here. Very neat. Let's get back to Popola. For the weapons you actually upgrade, you did a bit yet. Oh, I've read the stories and stuff? Nice. I feel like I'll upgrade Faith. If I can find some broken antennas.
So how was the village?
Oh, it was truly magnificent. There are no words.
Why didn't you come, Kaine?
Huh. Neat. Let's get back to Popola. She'll probably want to know what's going on in there.
Poor guy.
Hmm.
Do I go farm for a broken antenna? I wonder if I can. I'm just gonna... Okay, I'll check real quick. Like, give me a few minutes. Copium. I want to upgrade my weapon. I love upgrading weapons. Upgrading just always feels so good. Hours into the game. I feel like that's only like a quarter way through. I don't know how long the game is, but... Wait. I can't just avoid this mouse tail. Fast now. Still can't open that. Okay. Two broken antennas? Alright. Love that. Well, that's you, Kane. Oh, we're getting this easy.
It seems we have been shot.
Dented metal board. Wait, I should use this. Oh man. Dented metal board.
a million of them. Gotten like five so far total, I think. Maybe not even, maybe just four. I need one more. Oh, wait. I'm so close. Come on. I need one more. I need to get a little lucky. Oh, never mind. We're good. I need to clear it all out. Seems like that's all. Alright, we got plenty. We're golden. I'm feeling so good now. I feel like I'm gonna feel strong. Is that even one of the easiest to farm? Nice, okay. And it's like just convenient because it's close to the upgrade area, so.
How can I help? Need some work done on your weapon?
Yeah. Oh yeah, let's do it. Oh, it's so much stronger. What?
Come back.
Wait, what do I need?
How
to,
can I?
What
need
I need
some
for
work
next
done
level?
On your weapon?
I actually see what I need for the next level. Probably a lot. Elaborate machine and natural rubber. Okay. Only one of each, though. But they must be rare, then. You know what? No, that's fine. Let's go. Let's save at the main area. Let's save in the village. Wait, have I been climbing down to get down? That's a Royal Fern. I need you, actually. I thought I'd been climbing down to get down. When I didn't know you could just jump. I just wanted to try it here. That's nice. Really nice. Animation is still so funny. Of me going really fast or me falling off. Must open to talk to Popola. Well, fair enough.
Death dream certainly is a strange illness.
Yeah, it was something all right.
Even I, with my natural love for words, have no desire to visit that place ever again.
You guys did well. You've been making a lot of long trips lately. Are you sure you're not pushing yourself too hard?
I'm okay. I can't just sit around all day while Yona's sick, after all.
If you say so.
So, anything I can do for you?
Well, I suppose there is one thing I could use a hand with. Have you heard about our plans to repair the canal? The work probably won't happen for a while, but once it's done, we can use the canal for trade and travel and all kinds of useful things. Unfortunately, however, we're a bit behind schedule at the moment. If you're willing to help out, I'd really appreciate it.
No problem. What do you need?
Great. So, the man I originally asked to help on this project hasn't shown up for work in a few days.
Oh.
I'm starting to get a little worried, so maybe you can head over to Seafront and check up on him? I'll mark the location of his house on your map. He always carries a red bag over his shoulder, so he should be easy enough to find.
Got it.
Red bag. Wait, can I just jump off of there too?
A canal, is it? Fascinating. If we had a ferry, we could put these days of endlessly running about behind us.
Don't you just float everywhere anyway?
Do you think I am borne aloft by the winds, lad? It takes stamina to maintain this height.
Oh, really?
You could at least try to hide the utter dismay, you know.
Ooh, sorry. I do not have the ingredients for your stew yet. Okay, let's just go see front, I guess.
Excuse me, but have you seen my son?
I don't think so. Why? Is something wrong?
When I got home, I found a note from him that said he was leaving and not to look for him. What if he's left the village? Please, you have to help me. I'll pay you whatever you want. My son shouldn't be too hard to spot. He wears a very odd hat. You can see it from a mile away.
Okay. If I see him, I'll let him know his father's worried about him.
Where was he last seen? Very odd hat. Now I got distracted, but it's okay. Do I have any hints here? Alright, I guess I don't know where his son is. There's no hint. I don't know. I suppose the hint is that he has a funny looking, a weird looking hat, but it's really not that helpful. Oh, can I beat this guy now? Oh, look at him just destroy that elk. Oh, a guard break. Okay. Dude, look how much damage I'm doing though. I forgot lock on. Ooh. Dude, I'm kind of owning him this time though. Comparatively to before. Like the extra damage is like really helping out like a lot. Oh, he almost read me so hard. That was almost the sickest read I've ever seen. Souls. MP recovery rate plus 6%. Yo, and paralyze? That's really good. Complex machine. Oh wait, is that what I needed? With melee and magic, yeah. The 40%, or is it, this 30. 40% is the upgrade. One more upgrade. Speaking of that, though, should I give another, should I change the word on it? Wow, this could be on the second. I lose the item drop rate though. I see a simple machine for now? I don't remember. I need to pee again. Oh my gosh, I need to stop drinking water. I'm back. Okay. Do I take this? This is like, I feel like this is really good. And the MP rate goes really well with my other word. Oh no, with the weapon, not with the word. Speaking of which, maybe I should go for magic power somewhere. Oh, never mind. I have no magic power. No, it just doesn't say. There's no stat for magic power here. There's only magic defense and physical defense. I feel like this is really good. Alright, I'm just gonna do it. Goodbye to my item drop rate. -2%. What are you doing back there, Kaine? Oh, it's him.
Hey, are you the guy who's supposed to help repair the canal?
Awkward.
Hopefully sent me to...
Oh god, it's over. My life is over.
Surely you must realize nothing good can come of being involved with this particular endeavor.
Easy, Vice. Hey, so are you all right?
No. How many quests deep is this?
It's my wife. She left home a week ago and hasn't come back. I'm so worried I can't even focus on my work. Oh, my sweet dumpling, where are you?
That voice acted.
Oh, that's terrible. Would you like us to help you look for her?
Really? You do that for me?
Sure. But do you have any idea where we should start?
Well, she always used to enjoy drinking at the tavern with her friends.
All right, then I guess we'll start with them.
Thank you. This means the world to me. Oh, and by the way, my wife always carries a red bag just like mine.
Imagine, twinsies.
That, it might ring some bells.
I've met some odd couples in my day, but none who felt the need to wander about flaunting matching luggage.
That red bag.
You need to get with the times. Coordinated outfits are all the rage. Plus, these bags are special. We bought them for our anniversary.
Oh, that's kind of cute.
But now my sweet dumpling is gone. And it's all my fault. Oh, God.
Okay. Just stay calm. We'll go look for her, all right? You sit tight.
She's been missing a week and he hasn't...
I'm willing to bet that man knows more about his wife absconding than he's letting on.
She's been missing a week and he hasn't even gone to the tavern yet either? What a fool.
Hey there, I'm, looking for a woman carrying a red bag.
Are you now? Interesting. Did something happen to her?
She hasn't been home, and her husband's worried. Do you know anything about where she might be?
Trouble in paradise, is it? Oh, those two never change. Anyway, the short answer is no. She hasn't been around here, either. Though, come to think of it, she always got on well with the woman over at the tackle shop. Maybe you should try her?
I'll do that. Thanks.
Hey, what's the rush? You've got a cute face. Why not sit here and join me for a round? Or three?
Sorry, ma'am, but I'm not old enough to drink.
Jeez, calm down, lady. Yeah, Monka S indeed. Come on, man. Alright, tackle shop. Which one is the tackle shop? Oh, this is not the red bag.
Hey there, do you know a woman with a red bag by any chance?
A red bag? Oh, sure. Although now that I think about it, I haven't seen her in a while. Last time she came around, she mentioned something about leaving town. But I figured it was just idle talk.
Leaving town, huh? All right, thanks for your time.
Leaving town.
If she has truly left this charming hamlet, finding her may prove most difficult indeed.
I just hope she hasn't been attacked by shades or anything.
Oh, I've been such an idiot. Please.
What? We didn't tell him? Okay, whatever. Oh, wait. Is she up here? Ow, man. Poison. Certain enemy attacks are capable of inflicting poison status. Poison will clear up on its own after enough time has passed. But it can also be cured right away by using an antidotal. Okay. Or antidotal. Something. How much damage does it do? Not much. I'm taking it. But why am I taking it? There's no point in me taking it. I'd only be taking it because I'm a hoarder. Literally the only reason. Earning money tutorial? Oh, based. No music. I still can't go in here. Can't climb up these. Yeah, can't climb up those, okay. I don't think this is the right way yet, Ben. I'm guessing. I mean, there's not that many more places it could be, but we'll just check around here again. Oh. Well, that's kind of related.
Something about that shade seems rather odd.
Oh, was it her? I just killed her? Oh no!
Hey, look at this!
It is identical to the red satchel carried by the man who sent us on this mad quest. Perhaps it belongs to his spouse.
Oh no. Do you think the shades got her?
I fear it likely, lad. I sense no other activity in the immediate
vicinity. That's really sad.
Well, this is terrible. What are we supposed to say?
However difficult it may be, we've no choice but to tell the man the truth.
Yeah. Oh, that's terrible. Oh, man. I don't like that. That feel when you find Mancrick's wife? Near side quest? This is not a side quest. This is a mainline quest.
Did you find my sweet dumpling?
We didn't, but we got this off a shade.
Oh no! This is hers!
So our fears were correct.
Oh God, how could this happen to her? This is all my fault.
Should we ask? It's kind of none of our business. Honestly.
If I may, my good man, why did your wife leave home in the first place?
It's because I...
That's rough, buddy.
I think we should give him some time to himself, Vice.
Honey, I'm home. Good heavens, you're a...
Hey!
What's wrong?
Dumpling, you're not dead!
What in the world are you talking about? Oh, you found my bag. Thank you so much. I can't believe I went and dropped it like that.
Oh, this is such
a
relief.
What a baka.
Okay, seriously, what's going on?
Five minutes later.
I see. So, you found a shade with my bag and assumed I'd been attacked and killed?
I mean, that's not a bad assumption. Come on.
I'm just glad you're safe, Dumpling. But I'm also so sorry. This is all my fault. Oh, if I didn't eat that apple you were saving. Oh, God, I'm such an idiot!
Wow, that is drastic.
Listen, I promise I'll never eat anything of yours again. You just promised never to run away from home again, okay?
That would have been some, like, butterfly effect stuff.
Run away? Have you lost your mind? I just went to visit my parents.
Huh?
I told you about this. Going to see my family, gone for a week. Remember? Ugh, are you serious right now? Why don't you ever listen to me?
All right, this is his fault.
Lad, my brilliant intuition suggests we should beat a hasty retreat from these two with all speed.
I mean, in real life, I'd probably leave. Or, I don't know, you might be in that you might have that situation in real life where you're like, I'm a little too uncomfortable to leave right now. I guess I'm staying.
I can't believe you didn't listen to me, and you ate my apple. Ugh, you are the absolute worst.
What? Oh, like you're some perfect angel. You didn't even care enough about our anniversary to hang onto your bag.
Oh, no.
You, kid, I'm right about this, yeah? If anyone's wrong here, it's my wife, right?
Wait, you're asking me?
Oh, no. Why did I stay? Immediate, yeah, come on. All right, it's definitely the husband's. Okay, like, the husband is clearly not listening to his wife. Is she told him that she was gonna be gone for a week? It's definitely his fault, right? Like, I mean, come on.
Well, you shouldn't have eaten your wife's apple. That's not very nice.
That's not even the problem here, in my opinion. The apple's whatever.
But I was hungry, and it was just sitting there. Look, I'm glad you went looking for my wife and all, but that was low, friend. Low.
Uh-oh. Did I cross a line there?
Besides, it's pretty rich to come after me for an apple when you threw away my entire stamp collection.
Okay, this is a mistake.
You're damn right I did, and I'd do it again. You are nothing but a hoarding slob.
All right, that's pretty messed up, though.
You there.
A stamp
my husband's in the wrong here, isn't he?
A stamp collection is pretty... I mean, it's a collection. It can be a hobby, and it's pretty... It's, like, very harmless.
Pardon, but madam, I...
I mean, we don't know how bad of a hoarder he is, but why did I choose this? Oh, this was such a bad decision. My curiosity has gotten the best of me and I am punished greatly. I want to say it's her.
Well, to discard a man's precious hobby is a rather heinous act.
Tenma's a surgeon, not a therapist. Definitely both of them can get shot.
Oh, yeah, of course you'd take his side. Figures, you'd fit right in with his pile of collectible trash.
Collectible trash? Now see here!
Yikes. Are they just getting a divorce? Why am I still here after an hour?
Do you not even understand how frustrating this is, you colossal oaf? This is exactly what I hate about you.
Fine, hate me. I'll still sleep like a baby knowing I'm not an unreasonable hag like you.
Yikes.
Vice, what do I do?
You turn on your heel and walk away as fast as your legs can carry you, my good lad.
That's right, Vice.
That's it. I have had enough. Instead of belittling me, why don't you get a proper job? Everyone in the neighborhood treats me like dirt, and it's all because of my unemployed slob of a husband.
Wait, I thought he had a job.
Actually, I have a job now.
Wait, you what? You're kidding.
Why didn't you tell me? That's great.
Well, I sort of wanted it to be a surprise.
Oh, you big silly Billy. Well, this calls for a celebration.
What is happening?
I'm going to bake you a nice apple pie.
I can't tell if this is just marriage or if this is an unhealthy relationship. This might just be marriage.
I have no idea what just transpired, but it has utterly exhausted me.
Well, looks like they made up, so all's well that ends well?
In the course of all that madness, I have forgotten why we even came here in the first
place. You gonna go for some apple pie, though? That does sound good.
Oh, heck, the canal! We need to ask him about the canal!
Oh, yeah! Oops. Hey, fam.
I can't thank you enough for all your help.
Sure, but listen, we need to talk to you about the
canal. Literally, the only thing we did was find her bag, and then maybe make things worse in their relationship.
Oh, right! That's why you came here in the first place, huh? Well, now that my love life is rolling in clover again, I'd be more than happy to get going on the canal work.
Okay, guess we're talking to Popola now?
Heavens, that was exhausting.
Tell me about it. Anyway, let's go give Popola an update.
Why was that even necessary? Why even make that part of the story? It feels like they were just like trying to put in content at that point.
The couple with the red bags were a strange pair indeed. It boggles the mind to think their relationship can persist despite such intense squabbling.
Well, they looked pretty happy in the end at least. Maybe the secret to living a happy life is sharing your feelings, even when they're sort of mean and weird.
If you adopt such a strategy, I may leave for groceries one day and never return.
Your book. Okay. That was odd. That was very random. I'm not sure if that'll come back into play later or what, but... I've never been up here, have I? Ooh.
I don't need money. Just being with him makes me happier than anything.
I wanted to become a rich man for my girl. But it's not going as well as I'd hoped.
Aww.
Guess I'll just have to save up what little I can.
You're doing great, man. You're crushing it. Can now give me like fast travel to Seafront? I know it's not, nothing's like that far away from each other, but it is still like a little inconvenient, you know? At least yet. Maybe it'll expand.
Goodness. It sounds like the canal repairman had quite the problem on his hands. I'm glad everything turned out all right. Thank you so much for your help.
Don't mention it. I'm looking forward to seeing how the canal turns out. If you need anything else from us, just say the word.
Thanks, guys. Hey, wait!
Okay, I was like, what?
Huh?
I almost forgot. Yona is looking for you.
Okay.
Huh?
She said she needed something from you. Time to go play Big Brother for a bit, huh?
I guess so. Thanks, Popola. Popola said you needed something?
Yeah. A favor, actually.
What is it? I can't help if you don't tell me, sis.
Okay, I'm gonna say it. Ready?
I'm ready, Yona.
I need you to help my friend.
Your friend?
Yep. I have a friend. And we've been writing each other letters.
Seriously?
Is it me? IRL? Is it the letters in between the loading screen?
A pen pal. How delightful.
So who is this friend?
Well, he's kinda...
He? It's a guy?
Calm down, man.
Yes, and he's sick and in a whole lot of trouble. And I know that you and Vicey are the only ones who can help him.
Vicey?
Tell me about this guy.
He lives in this really big house down south. And he's super nice, and he's my friend. So you have to help him. Please?
Yona, listen.
Please?
Great. Now what do I do?
I mean... Really, curing the Black Scroll is way more important, probably. But I want her to be happy. Right? It's a big decision. I don't know how this affects the outcome, or what the outcome can be. All right, fine.
Fine. I'll see what I can do.
Yay! Thank you! Please help him.
Whoops.
Great. Yona's got a boyfriend.
Is something amiss, lad?
That's not what it means.
Your voice is trembling.
No, it isn't. Shut up!
Alright, man. I'm dead. You gotta learn how to swim.
Are you alright, lad?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You have lost health. You must be more careful.
I don't actually know if Roland is faster or not. Oh, I can fight it again.
How can these creatures let us dispatch them without complaint? And what would make them appear in this area in the first place? This is hardly what one would call especially fertile ground.
Back off for a little bit. No loot? Just because I already killed you? Okay. Fair enough. Percent drop increase mattered. No, you hate to see it. I mean, 2% is a lot. Anything about Phantasy Star drop rates? He's in that house. Oh wait, that's spooky. 2% is basically guaranteed. That's the gacha mindset I need. Am My character's birthday is June 6th. I have medicinal herbs. Okay, I have meat. Okay. This is not a good idea.
We have been waiting for you, sirs. Please, right this way.
I have a bad feeling about this. Man, can you move a little bit faster? Wait.
Please, wait here.
What if this is the castle in that dream? That'd be insane. It's not a castle, but...
Waiting's a bitch. Just let me know if any shades show up, okay?
Okay, what are you gonna do? I'm just gonna chill? Alright. This is interesting. I mean, the guy told us to wait there. I don't know, man. Maybe we should listen to him.
This one bit.
What's the matter, Vice? Scared?
I mean, I am a little bit. But it makes me think of older. Alright, yeah. Actually, yeah. I don't have a save point, so I feel like I need to complete this. There's a keyhole marked moon here. What is this? This is 999? Darkness. I have a feeling we're gonna get in trouble.
Hey, where'd Kaine go?
Yikes.
I knew this was a terrible idea. Haunted manors and the like. Why does no one ever listen to me?
Oh, man. Oh, well, we lost Kaine. I guess that's it. Can I jump off this? Jump up here? Seems no bueno.
It's locked.
I shouldn't have started this, I don't think. I don't know how long it lasts, but... Okay, let's go back to where we were then. Unless any of these are destructible. I don't think they are, though. Where'd that come from? This is rather creepy.
What's this? The picture has changed.
I would not have noticed. They're getting older. Oh, that is spoogey.
It looks like it's in pain. It's kind of scary.
Yes, come now. Brave faces. Onward and upward, eh?
Yona, this was the worst idea ever. If we die, this is Yona's fault. Hidden items. Hang on, don't. I'm gonna do my first tutorial here. So requires iron may be hidden in the field. Search for okay. Totally not useful. Moon key, okay. I'm afraid that things are gonna change significantly when we keep backtracking. Changed since last time.
Shades!
What foul hole did they crawl from?
I'm so sluggish, too. Experience rate plus 4. That's not bad. This is a cool area though. Like, it is creepy, but I think it's actually like pretty neat. Force perspective too and everything. Alright, darkness and star keys. Is this you and a sick
You're
friend?
A male. Young. Not even 20.
You figured that out from my footsteps?
It's not hard, once you know how.
Then I suppose I should tell you about my friend Vice.
I only heard one set of footsteps.
Grimoire Vice does not strut about like a common land mammal. But enough of this introductory chatter. Let us hear your tale.
My name is Emile. I'm the master of this man.
Oh! I know this name. I think we're meant to... I mean... Jordan, we know this name in Automata, right? Like, I know who it is, but... We also... Like, we learned that name in Automata as well, right? Unless I just knew. Okay. Yeah. So now, how is that related to this?
So you're the one who sent the letters?
Letters? What are you talking about?
Of course you don't know. Such a thing would be far too simple.
Okay, this is interesting.
No, stay back.
Huh?
I'm sorry. It's my eyes. Anything I look at gets turned to stone.
Oh, dang.
That's why I live with this blindfold.
What a remarkable skill. I've never heard of such a thing.
Anyway... I suppose my butler might know more about the letters you received. This key here can unlock any door in the manor, so if you'd like my assistance...
No, please, don't trouble yourself. We can get around on our own.
Those keys would be pretty helpful, though.
Oh, right. Sure. Well, here's the key, then. The butler's quarters are at the far end of the manor. Let me at least give you a map. It's a big place, and I don't want you to get lost.
Okay, good, good. Oh, but we don't have the darkness key.
Vice, what should we do about Kaine?
Leave her. That woman is capable enough on her own.
Jeez, remind me to never get on your bad side.
Star key is here. A lot of doors here. There's 7 doors here. I'm for the grad class. Have a good rest of your day. See you later. All right, Shane. Thanks for stopping in. I appreciate it. Hope you have a good day. And hope should see you tonight. I'm pretty sure. Pretty darn sure I'll see you tonight.
Butler, or at least a remarkable likeness of one. I knew this was a trap. Curse my brilliant intuition.
I could really use a save. I'm gonna go to the bathroom one more time. I gotta pee one more time, and then we'll finish this out. Hopefully find a save soon. Alright. You need to hydrate more? I need to hydrate less. There is a point where you're hydrating too much. I think the sweet spot is where... What was that?
Shades!
Item drop rate plus 6%? I mean, 6% is a lot better than 2%. I love loot. I haven't even seen that yet. Open. Dang. I gotta check it again. Oh, that was weird. Spooky. I didn't even know this needed a key. Hello, sir.
Well,
is that another one?
You look so happy. I was blocking that one. I was parrying that 100%. I was so prepared.
It moves.
What's going on here?
Sir?
What is this?
Oh, this is my butler. He helps me out around
this
the
is
manor.
So unnerving.
He's a good man at heart, but a bit inflexible, almost like a statue.
Yes, and I do apologize for that, Master Emil.
I doubt he's even human.
We're here because my sister received some letters from this manor.
Yes, I wrote those letters. Please forgive my impertinence. As you may know, Master Emil, deeply pained by his eyes, has shut himself away from the world. He suffers greatly behind that blindfold, and I feel it is my duty to help however I can. I heard tale of the exploits of an emerging hero, and so I sent a letter to you under Master Emil's name. But I received a response from one Miss Yona instead.
Wait, so Yona's pen pal is you?
It is, sir.
Weird.
My letters merely requested that you come to the manor. I meant no ill intent.
I believe Yona saw the exchange somewhat differently.
Yeah, sounds like she misunderstood the situation.
Regardless, I am quite pleased to see you here. Long have I dreamed of the day we might be able to do something about Master Emil's eyes.
Wait, is he gonna try to take ours?
I see.
Yes, well, I am afraid we, or at least this lad beside me, is neither hero nor physician, so if you'll excuse us.
Please, we're so close. The cure for Master Emil's condition is located in this very manor.
Then why don't you just go get it?
Alas, the location of the cure has become a den for those abominable shades, and I lack the skill to combat them. I beg of you, defeat the shades and restore Master Emil's sight.
You know this is an impossible task. Why would you ask it of our guests?
Well, you've no more time to waste, so...
It's okay. We'll do it.
See here, lad. This is no time to play the hero.
People need to look out for each other, Vice. Plus, we have to find Kaine anyway.
1,000 thank yous. I owe you a debt that can never be repaid.
We should ask about Kaine.
I'm really sorry for all the trouble. My butler cares so much for me, but for him to make such outlandish requests...
I'm scared how backtracking is going to change again.
But hey, at least I can petrify your enemies.
That's
true. That's going to be some help, right? Can't let you do this on your own. So I'll be right here if you need me. Maybe my eyes can be useful for once.
Actually, that's kind of insane. It has changed again. I think this has changed again. Yeah, it has changed again. Dang. My consumables more, as is tradition in every game. The one hits with Blade of Treachery. Heavy sword. No thanks. This is just way worse. No, I mean, this is a level 2 weapon, so. Even at level 1, its power is like 140. Not sure you use the drops once? Gotcha. I mean, they do seem useful. Yeah. 30 seconds of half damage is pretty good in like a boss fight or something. I need to move. I am stuck here. Defense drop time. I swear I'm blocking. I'm trying to block at least. I don't think I've blocked a single thing though. Fighting with this perspective is hard to do. Alright, we're gonna call it here. I think this is probably gonna be I think this is, yeah, this is going to be a big room, so I think now's a good time to call it. And, no, this is fun. This is great. I miss this game. A lot of cool, I love the Forest of Myth. That was really cool. And this manor is, got a really creepy vibe. I think it's really cool. Alright. Thanks for being here, guys. Try to be here next week. Not 100% sure. I feel like my schedule lately has just been kind of whatever I can. Or on Saturdays, so. But yeah, thanks for being here. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day, great rest of your weekend. And I'll see you later. See ya.